slower buoyant.
The story of Cat Island is an outrageous story. One that, when I first read it, I thought, oh my God, this can't be real.
I knew a lot about internment, Japanese internment, Asian American history. But one thing that was very unique to this story was this War Dog project that I had no idea about.
The story happened about 7 years ago, but I think it's very relatable. Throughout the 7 years, it didn't lose anything from its core values.
We follow a major who is a World War II U.S. Army officer who is overseeing a program to train dogs to hunt and attack people of Japanese ethnicity using Japanese-American soldiers as test subjects.
We had originally talked about this all being on a dolly, and after kind of seeing this location, which we fell in love with, it just became a matter of like, well, the only way to cover it in the size and the scope that Attila wanted was to switch to Steadicam. And that's been a big change, but I think it's working out really well.
It is being done all in one take. I've never done that with a dog before. If anything, in order to trick things with dogs, we do a lot of takes. We do different angles and things to make it look like a dog's doing something. And so that's one of the tricks you use when you work with dogs. So to have that taken away is kind of scary.
For me, America is not a geographical location of birth. It's a nation of immigrants with different backgrounds, different ethnicities, different religions, who nonetheless believe in a shared set of ideals and principles. And that's what I hope this movie can help us remember.
There are some really hard lessons to learn here. I think history is important because we need to go back and then we need to examine the horrors and the conditions of this.
So the purpose of this film is to connect with people and just to overcome all the challenges. We obviously need support. If you believe this story should come to life, please donate, share the project, spread the word. Thank you.